And welcome into the ballpark. Happy to have you with us. We've got baseball on the show. It's the Tampa Bay Rays going up against the New York Yankees. First pitch coming your way next. So almost ready to get underway. And towing the slab here, Nestor Cortes Jr.
Well, he's not a scout's dream because of the height, an undersized pitcher, but the heart is there and knows how to work the corners of the plate, add and subtract velocity to keep the hitters off balance.
Now up for Tampa Bay, Yandy Diaz. Started at the 3-1, now a check, and down to first we go. Didn't go.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
And now it's Brandon Lau.
2-1.
Squirts away a little bit. Well done behind the dish. And he deals.
Ball.
And another ball.
Full count.
Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another.
Really great change of speeds. He goes off the off-speed to the fastball, and the hitter doesn't know what's coming next.
And here it comes. And ball four, two aboard.
Well, interesting. He went with the off speed and walked the hitter. Man, you got to challenge the guy with the fastball.
Now it's Randy Arozarena. The pitch. 3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
Now, that sets up a really big at bat in this game. These are the moments when everyone in the stadium gets really locked in.
Bases loaded, nobody out. Now here's the Tampa Bay cleanup hitter, Isaac Paredes.
They need a strikeout, and you need a ball perhaps on the ground for a double play or get yourself a pop-up, something, but you've got to make some pitches. But if he can battle and get through this, he can earn some points.
This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. Makes the catch, and there's one gone. All right, let's take a look at the Rays lineup. And the key to victory for them here, get their starter some run support early.
Boog, if they can get him that run support early, it's likely the other team folds because they know how dominant he can be once he gets settled in. So put pressure on that other team right away. Jump out to a lead early, and a few runs is going to feel like 30.
Bases loaded, one away.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
Kicks and fires. Line to left. Drops into the glove. Runner tagging from third. The throw is offline and he's in to score. On the board first, it's one zip.
Sometimes that can be a little tough to score on. It was hit so hard that getting back to the bag, the tag, takes a little bit of time by the time that outfielder catches it, but a really good job of getting that run in from third. It's great to get on the board in the first frame of the ball game, but here's an opportunity for them to really open things up with a couple of runners on. Let's see if they can cash in.
And the pitch. And that's off the inside edge. And now 3-1. Traffic on the bases with one already in. And we're just getting started here in the top of the first. And now the count is full. And another power hitter lurking in the on-deck circle. And a pitch. And there's ball four.
Now Well, he's been in a very giving mood today.
And now it's Jose Siri. Two outs.
Ball two.
Is lifted in the air. Judge is there. He's got it. And that's the third out. So they get one, but end up leaving the bases loaded. On to the bottom of the first. It's the Rays one and the Yankees nothing. Back in New York. And the right-hander with the good curveball, Zach Eflin. Chris, what should we keep an eye on here with him?
He really relies on working down in the zone with that heavy sinker he's got. You know, it's not as popular to throw that pitch today as it used to be because, you know, guys are looking to hit balls down in the zone, get them up in the air. It's very important for him when facing same-side hitters to be able to get it in, especially early in the count, and to opposite guys, be able to throw it at that front hip and run it over the inside corner.
On the ground, into the outfield, base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Batting second.
And now big number 99, Aaron Judge. And a pitch. That misses the zone. 2-1. At the belt and fires. Wouldn't chase that time. Tying run is at first as the Rays try and punch back down a run. And Judge takes a strike.
Well, I think that pitch surprised all of us. Right down the middle, doesn't get a swing. Not very often you see a hitter lay off a cookie like that.
Judge rips that one, and he makes the catch. And there's one down. As we take a look now at the New York Yankees lineup. Chris, this is a lineup offensively that could be really good for years to come.
They're deep, first and foremost, but the way that they can manipulate their personnel for matchups and everything else, it's very intelligent the way that they use their team. And I think it creates a little bit of uncertainty for opposing teams, especially in a big game, big series.
In the dirt, LeMahieu into scoring position on the wild pitch, and there goes the double play possibility.
Well, that right there erases the chance at the inning-ending double play, so good job on the bases to move up on the wild pitch. Changes the outlook of the inning in a pretty big way.
On the corner for a strike. And that one missing low. LeMahieu over at second, one down. Fights it off, he'll see another. Out towards right center, that's well struck. It's a gives him the lead in the first. It's 2-1.
He ran the count full and saved his best swing for last. That was a battle, and he won.
This one absolutely screamed out of here, Singy. A laser. Statcast tells us it was 112 miles an hour off the bat.
Yeah, it left in a real hurry and didn't go that far because of the launch angle being a little flatter, but clearly it had all the velocity it needed to leave the yard.
One out, base is empty. And now the DH, Giancarlo Stanton. Hawaii to kick the pitch. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming.
He hasn't gotten the result yet, but he's got to feel pretty confident. Three foul balls in a row, he's right on this pitcher.
Ninth pitch of the at-bat due next. And yeah, that skips into dirt. Outside, and that is ball four. That's a great at-bat. He saw a lot of pitches and earned a walk.
I don't think he really wanted to pitch to him right there anyhow.
One gone, runner at first. Anthony Rizzo stepping in down for the Yankees. Over to Lau. And that's two. Another look at the long ball for the Yankees. And it's now a 2-1 ball game. It's Major League Baseball on the show. Top of the second. And the batter now, Jose Caballero.
Well, after scoring runs, this is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
Now this one's crushed down the line. Looking. Foul ball. Got him looking. Couldn't pull the trigger on a fastball at the knees. Rene Pinto next to hit for the Rays. One down, base is empty. Popped up. Under it. Corrals it. And there are two down.
Up next for Tampa Bay.
So the Rays batting order turns over. Yandy Diaz now.
It's so hard to slow yourself down when you see that juicy breaking ball, but the most success happens when you try to take that right back up the middle approach.
Rays down by a run here at the top of the second. To third. And that one finds its way through. And that extends the inning.
Just one of those seeing high base hits through the infield. He just kind of rolled over on it a little bit, but sometimes those can find a hole and get you a knock.
Lau at the plate. On its way to the corner. Drifts towards it. And he can't quite get there. It's a foul ball. And another ball.
I think he wanted that call on the upper part of the zone, but just didn't get it. Now he's just trying to get a better feel for how much it missed so he can adjust his sights just a little bit.
And now 2-2. And there's a ball.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
Randy Arozarena waits on deck. Good job to fight that one off. Good battle here. About to be the eighth pitch of the at-bat. Battling here as he fouls it away. The pitch. Foul ball, and it remains a full count. And a pitch. Swing and a foul ball at the plate. They'll do it again. Two outs. And down on strikes he goes. He battled for a long time, but it finishes with a strikeout. You can't be mad at yourself after an at-bat like that one. No runs, one hit, no errors, and a man left. Now to the bottom of the second. It's the Yankees 2, the Rays 1. Back for more from the Bronx. Now it's the second baseman, Gleyber Torres. One, two now.
Ball.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
The pitch. Ground ball left side. It's through for a hit. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
Batter seven.
No left. Here's field. Alex Verdugo. And the right-hander deals. That one is absolutely belted. Siri going back on this one. And that one's gone. And they add on. It's 4-1.
Already playing with the lead, and now they're celebrating a home run. They're having a great time out there. Up and in can be such a tough pitch for the hitters. You have to keep your hands above the baseball, and that's exactly what he did. He caught it out front and drove it out of here.
And stepping in for the Yankees, Anthony Volpe. Now a screamer into the outfield. A Rosarena hauls it in, and there's one away.
Batting ninth, the catcher, Austin.
Austin Wells, stepping in now for the Yankees. Still in the second, already at 44 pitches, so some concern there. To the right side, and he picks it up, and he'll put it in his pocket. Fouls that off to the left, and we'll do it again. Fouls it back with two strikes. Here comes a pitch. In the air, out to center. And it drops in. So now back to the top of the order.
Up next to the Yankees.
Now it's DJ LeMahieu digging in.
LeMahieu.
Here's a 1-1. And there he goes. The 1-1 is fouled off. The pitch. That one out to right. Brings it in.
The center fielder, number 99, Aaron.
Now it's Aaron Judge up to the plate. He's not going to get cheated up there.
No, he's not. He's looking to do damage with every swing he takes.
Kicks and deals. Hit hard on the ground is short. Gets him easily, ends the inning. Another look at the long ball for the Yankees. It's now a 4-1 ball game. Major League Baseball is on the show. top half of the third inning and stepping in for the Rays, Randy Arozarena.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
And now the lefty.
Ball.
Go Chris through the early stages. He hasn't been very efficient in terms of the pitch count. He's going to need to get some quick outs if he's going to get deeper into this game. Wouldn't chase that time. It is interesting, though, when you consider the way the game is run now, doesn't even matter that much if your starter doesn't go that deep because teams are really aggressively building their bullpens. Hit hard. That gets through. And the leadoff man aboard.
Up next to Tampa Bay, the third baseman, Isaac Paredes.
Isaac Paredes now. Kicks and fires.
No,
just missed.
Well, these Rays did a great job, Boog, of just waiting for the right pitch to come their way, and I'm seeing very patient at-bats out of them. The numbers kind of speak for themselves with the four walks. They've done a great job of not trying to do too much and just staying disciplined.
And here it comes. And a swing and a miss. And there's one away.
He's really good hitting the baseball the other way. So credit the pitcher for having him out in front of that pitch. Clearly he had him fooled.
Harold Ramirez at the dish. Now snap throw to first. And he's back in there.
Another thing I love is how they've allowed the game to come to them. They're not forcing the issue when they're on offense. And when you force and get anxious, it starts.
Arozarena on the move. And a 2-1 hammered but foul. The pitch. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. And a pitch. And another ball. Outside, and that is ball four.
They just keep handing out gifts, Boo. Were we supposed to bring something?
See, I think just our presence is the present. One down. Richie Palacios next to hit for the Rays. And the pitch. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Arozarena at second. Ramirez at first. One gone. Pitch misses. And the count is 2-2. Movement in the Yankees pen. Luke Weaver up and throwing. Two on, one out. Got him lifting. Now two away.
Well, you got to be ready to swing the bat with a runner in scoring position and few strikes. Just put the ball in play somewhere, and you've got a chance. Very frustrating for him, I'm sure. See if the next guy can pick him up.
Jose Siri, next to hit for the Rays. There's a strike. Laboring here. About to throw his 30th pitch of the inning. That misses. Now 2-2.
It's a good take.
headed down the line. Soto really on his horse for it. Tries to make the play, but it's foul. And another ball. Jose Caballero up next for the Rays. Yankees up by three. We're here in the top half of inning number three. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. At the belt and fires. And he walked him. It wasn't easy, but he earned that walk after a long at bat.
He just hasn't had great command of his pitches in this one. Definitely more walks than you'd like to see.
So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Jose Caballero. Bases loaded, two down. High fly ball out of the left center field. Judge getting an angle on it. Makes the play, and it's out number three. And the Rays leave them loaded, and they trail it 4-1. Back here in New York, set for the bottom of the third. Here's Juan Soto.
Right fielder, Juan Soto.
Next pitch is outside.
You know, these Yankees doing a good job of simply getting the bat on the ball in this game, and the numbers back that up. It's tough to remember the times they've actually swung and missed at a pitch because it really hasn't happened. They've made contact on nearly 100% of their swings.
Right-hander kicks, deals. And that's ball four.
First base.
His ability to draw walks has been something that's been part of his career since day one.
And at first, and now it's Giancarlo Stanton. Runner at first with no outs here. The 1-1 is fouled off. Missed.
2-2.
Keeps the at bat going with a foul ball. Back down on strikes. One gone here. Anthony Rizzo steps to the plate.
Anthony Rizzo.
Swings through that one for strike two.
1-2.
Gets a piece and stays alive. Man at first, one away. And misses on the fastball up in the zone for the strikeout.
Now batter, second baseman.
Here's Gleyber Torres. The pitch. Bounce to the left side. Over to Diaz. What a play. Inning over. One left for the Yankees, but they lead it 4-1. Welcome back, and now on the mound to start the fourth, Luke Weaver.
Well, at this point of the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
So digging in, Rene Pinto.
The catcher, Rene Pinto.
In the air, out towards left center, Verdugo hauls it in, and there's one away.
The first baseman, number two,
Yandy Diaz. Next to hit for the Rays. One down, base is empty. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Right-handed reliever. Swing and a line drive. Base hit out of the center field. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Hitting is really easy for some guys. One thing that I can see already, his bat stays in the zone on plane for an extended period of time. And guys like that, they have a high contact rate and they have more barrels because of that bat being on plane. And even when you don't get it great, it's still hit hard enough to dunk something in like that in front of the center fielder.
And the righty deals. Yeah. On the inside corner for a strike. The Yanks leading by three, top half of inning number four. That's a little bit low.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with the three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Three balls, two strikes, the count. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
Well, there he gets the slider in on his hands, and it just eats him up. You know, it's hard to get the bat around on a pitch like that in tight. You just feel like you're crowded on the inside part of the plate, can't get any extension. That's one he definitely should have laid off of.
Diaz off of first with two away. And another ball. And it's fouled away.
A defensive swing right there. Some cheese on the inside part of the plate. But the hands are still stinging after that one.
Two outs. That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. Righty delivers. Comes up empty as he chases that one in the dirt. In time, the 2-3 strikeout ends the inning. The Rays strand just the one, and this is still a 4-1 ball game. Back now in the Bronx, John Chabi and Chris Singleton with you. And leading off the bottom of the fourth, Alex Verdugo. Left-hand hitter waits. There's a swing and a drive. The Rosarena raging back towards the wall. And gone. Another homer. His second home run of the game. And they add to their lead. It's 5-1.
And that shot makes their grip on the lead even tighter. Not every home run is a majestic blast off the bat, and even though he hit it pretty well, it was anything but a sure thing to get out. But today, the conditions were right. He got just enough of it, and I think the backspin really helped that thing carry.
And now it's going to be Anthony Volpe. Nobody on, nobody out with a run in. We're here in the bottom of the fourth. Next offering upstairs.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit.
Well, I'm sure he feels really good about that one. Just kept it simple. Played pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from. And there's just no one there to knock it down.
So, man aboard. And here's the catcher, Austin Wells.
Ball two.
This one in the dirt. Runner holds. Count goes to 2-1. And a 2-1 on the way. Wouldn't chase that time. All right, so Monument Park out there in center field at Yankee Stadium. Have you gotten a chance to check that out?
Boog, I have seen it more after my playing career than I did as a player. But as a broadcaster, many times entering and exiting through the center field fence, particularly in the playoffs, get a chance to take a glimpse over. And I got to say, you do get some goosebumps.
Back to work, 3-2 now. Got him. One out. Here at Newt, Tyler Alexander will take over here.
Now, well, they didn't get much length out of their starter in this one, so they've got a lot of outs to eat up in that bullpen. I think they'll look for some length out of him right here if they can get it.
Back to the top of the lineup, and next for New York, DJ LeMahieu. And a pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2.
Yeah, you have to connect the past with the present, and they did a really nice job of the Monument Park out there where you can go and walk through and see the legends. This is New York, and it is the greatest city, I would say, in the country, if not the world. So you expect them to build a ballpark that's going to be incredibly rich in that tradition.
Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
Thought it was a pretty good pitch. Top of the strike zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Hitters, especially with two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger.
And now the lefty cuts on it and misses. That's a strikeout. Snuck the fastball by him. One scores in the inning coming on this solo home run. It's now 5-1. Back at Yankee Stadium, all set for the start of the inning. Here's the third baseman, Isaac Paredes.
Come on, New York.
Hard hit left side. And the leadoff hitter retired in the fifth. So now the DH spot, Harold Ramirez.
Go, Yanks.
One down, base is empty. Fought off foul.
A little tardy on that fastball. He's going to have to get it going a little quicker. Get that front foot down.
One and two now. Fights it off. He'll see another. And it falls. So a man aboard now with one away.
The right I don't know how he's able to shoot that pitch the other way and still put something on it. That pitch was inside, and he let it get really deep. So pretty incredible hands to fight it off and still get good wood on it.
Next to hit, Richie Palacios. And that one pulled foul. Two-two now. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Ramirez leads off first with one away. Good job to fight that one off. Out to short, base hit. Quick throw back in. Lead runner holds it second with one gone.
Well, patience and discipline paid off right there as he got into an advantage count. Not much to this one other than just a willingness to go the other way and put the ball in play. That's a team at bat right there. Nice job of staying back and letting the ball get deep. Could be a chance here for them to start clawing back into this ballgame.
Rizzo, off balance feed. There's one out there, but that's all they'll get.
Tough play right there. Didn't really have enough time to set his feet and make a strong, accurate throw. Had to rush it, but he got it off, and he got it there in time to get that out at second base.
Now up for Tampa Bay, Jose Caballero. Two on, two outs. Line drive. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out, and that'll do it. So the Rays strand a pair. They're down 5-1. Bottom of the inning. Juan Soto now. Next pitch is outside. Bullpen movement for the Rays. Sean Armstrong preparing to come on if needed. That one finds the zone. It's two and two.
Two strikes.
And another ball. Swings and misses. Struck him out.
This guy will throw any pitch in any count. 3-2. He goes off speed. Gets the out.
Giancarlo.
And here is Giancarlo Stanton. The pitch. Fouls one off. 2-2. Base is empty, one away. Last half of inning number 5. Stays alive. Here comes a pitch. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout. And here is Anthony Rizzo.
The first baseman, Anthony Rizzo.
Two outs, base is empty. The 1-1 is fouled off. Left-hand batter waits.
Ball. 2-2.
That's ripped. Base hit. And that keeps the inning going.
Well, that was one of those high-percentage advantage counts where batting averages are just so much higher. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Off the mark there. And it's 2-1. Rizzo, the runner at first with two gone. Right through there for a strike. Two outs. Broken bat, and it's popped up. Alexander brings it in, and that'll do it. The Yanks lead one. They're up 5-1. Here at New Yankee Stadium in the Bronx. All right, we go to the top half of inning number six. Here's the catcher, Rene Pinto. The 1-1. Breaking ball in there for a strike. Next one misses, and that's ball two. Swings through it, and that's a strikeout.
I'm not sure that was the exact location the pitcher wanted, but it worked. He got the swing and miss, and I'm sure a bit of sigh of relief after seeing that one go through the zone.
And now the first baseman, Yandy Diaz. And the right-hander deals. Not even close there. And that's ball two. On the ground, right side, and that's just foul. The Yankees leading by four, and we're the top half of the sixth. On the ground, right side, Torres slings to first. Two quick outs to open the top of the sixth.
Well, he didn't recognize changeup earlier enough. Got out in front a little bit, rolled over on it, and beat it into the ground.
Two outs, bases empty. Brandon Lau, next to hit for the Rays. Two down, nobody on. That one at 95 missed up top. And it's 2-1. Fly ball down the line. This has got a chance, and it is foul.
That's a really good pass of the ball right there. Just a little bit too quick. He's got to find a way just to travel a hair more.
Two outs. Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. Righty to the plate. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Two on the way. On the ground to the left. LeMahieu gets it to first. Rays retired in order. Offense held in check there. 7-8-9 due up in the home half of the inning. It's the Yankees 5, the Rays 1. Now the left fielder, Alex Verdugo. And the way he's going in this one, we've been waiting for his spot to come around again.
All right, listen, everyone. Stop what you're doing right now. This guy's got two home runs already. Now he's going for number three.
Swing and a pop-up in foul ground. Drifts towards it. Makes the grab, one down.
The batter number 11, shortstop, Anthony
Volpe, now at the plate. One out, base is empty. Ripped on a line to center. Siri pulls it down, two down.
Man, that's one of those at-bats where you have to remind yourself it's about the process. He did everything right there. Nothing to show for it. But in your mind, you have to convince yourself that it was a very good at-bat.
Hot shot to first base, and he snags it to end the inning. 1-2-3, go the Yankees. They lead this one, though, 5-1. Back in the Bronx, we go to the top of the seventh, and stepping in for the Rays, Randy Arozarena. The pitch comes up empty. That's strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
The 1-2. The other way. And it stays fair. And that rolls into the corner. Soto gets it back in quickly. And they hold him at second. Maybe this is going to be the moment they start the comeback.
Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
So, man aboard, Isaac Paredes digs in now. That's towards center. Judge has it sized up. Nabs it. Runner tagging for third. And he's in safely at third with one out.
Now batting, designated hitter, Harold Ramirez.
Harold Ramirez, next to hit for the Rays.
The goal is to give your teammate a chance to score from third. There's a few ways he can get it done, but his best chance is to drive one in the air. Oh. Look for the right pitch up and then smoke it.
Arozarena stands at third with one gone in the inning. Next offering is downstairs.
Get ready for some action here. Good RBI guy at the plate. Runners in scoring position and a hitter's count.
In for a strike. Now it's 3-2. Down the line. And no one could get to it. It's a foul ball. Right through there. Got him. And there's two away.
Frustrating end to the at-bat for the hitter, and I'm sure that's going to sit on him for a little while. You want to be ready to hit the fastball. Sometimes you can overthink things, and I think that was the case right there.
Two outs. And a foul ball. The 1-2. That one back up the middle and it gets through. In comes the run from third. It's 5-2.
Puts a run on the board and picks up an RBI. Once you get the ball by the pitcher, there's a lot of base hits up the middle, even on ground balls. So a nice job to use that big hole and get himself a hit.
Jonathan Loaisiga on the pitch here. Jose Siri, next to hit for the Rays. Swing and a miss as he was out front. The Yanks leading by three here in the top half of inning number seven. That one down the line, and he grabs it foul. And a pitch. That one way outside, and it's 2-2. Action in the pen down there. Clay Holmes getting ready to go. And there's a rocket into the outfield. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out.
Back-to-back base hits. Everything was on time and fluid in that swing. Got a pitch he could get the barrel on and lined it into center for the knock. Those always feel good. Now let's see if they can string something together. Make it a little more interesting.
At the plate, Jose Caballero. And a count one and two. Oh, right to the backstop. And two in scoring position now, thanks to that wild pitch.
Going to have to buckle down and make a pitch or two to get out of this little jam he's worked himself into after the two-out hit, then that wild pitch. Good time to step off, take a deep breath.
Tying run at the plate.
Full count.
Rene Pinto, next to bat for Tampa. The tying run at the plate. Foul ball left side. He'll see another. Three, two now. Battling here as he fouls it away. Eighth pitch of the at bat coming up. Outside, and that is ball four. That's a great at bat. He saw a lot of pitches and earned a walk.
A great back and forth in that at bat. He had to play off some really close pitches, and somehow Boogie found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
Here comes. Now a bullet to second base, but he's got it to end the inning. But they pick up one run on the RBI single. It's now 5-2. Back after this on the show. And we're back, ready to go for the last half of the inning. Now the third baseman, DJ LeMahieu.
The third baseman, DJ.
And he deals.
Mayhew.
So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Kicks and fires. Bows it off. Still 1-2.
Come on, Yankee, let's go.
The pitch. He goes down looking.
Well, he wasn't happy with that called third strike in and off the plate, and I think he's right. I mean, that miss, it's a really tough one, though, for an umpire back there, so I don't think you can be too mad at him. It looks like it's in the zone the entire way coming in until those last few feet, so I'd say pretty easy to understand why he'd say it clipped the corner. Just a nice pitch.
Here comes Aaron Judge. Base is empty, one away. Here at the bottom of the seventh. On the ground to third, Paredes. Zips it to first. Judge out on the play.
The batter, the right fielder, Juan Soto.
And now it's Juan Soto. And it was a homer back in the first inning that got his day started at the plate.
Yeah, Boog, a two-run blast as fans were just still getting into their seats here at the ballpark. So if you showed up late to this one, you missed out on a big moment early on.
Kicks and deals. Swing and a miss, and that's strike two.
Throwing the ball well, and they need this scoreless inning in relief right here. Been doing a good job keeping them in striking distance.
Two down, nobody on. Foul ball still, a 1-2 count. And a pitch. Fights that one away, still 1-2. The pitch. Fouls it off, still 1-2. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Yanks held in check, and it remains 5-2. Now on the bump, Caleb Ferguson. Here's the Rays leadoff hitter, Yandy Diaz. The Rays in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. I need a good at-bat out of him right here.
And now the lefty. Bounce to third. Handled by LeMahieu. Tosses to first. Leadoff man is out here in the eighth.
The batter number eight. Second baseman, Brandon Lau.
Now the number two hitter, Brandon Lau. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Left-hand hitter waits. In the air, center field. Judge hauls it in for the out. Two down.
Now back. The left fielder, Randy Arozarena.
Two outs, base is empty. And now Randy Arozarena.
Got to keep things airtight defensively right here. On your toes, ready to make a play. If you can get this to the ninth with a three-run lead, it should be a W.
Drilled out towards left center field. That's well struck. And that one hops the wall. In safely with a double, his second of the day.
Oh, this has been a really nice game at the plate for him. He looks locked in. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great.
Isak Paredes, next to hit for the Rays. Belt and fires. Two
ball
balls,
two
strikes to count with two outs.
Two balls, two strikes.
Runner at second, two down, and we're in the top of the eighth. Two outs.
Full count.
In the dirt. He's in there. Arozarena up to third on the wild pitch.
Even with a good secondary lead, sometimes it's hard to see just how far that ball's gotten away from the catcher. And if you can make it to third base, pretty much standing up. Well, that time, he seemed to have a pretty good read, gets to third safely, and now he's just 90 feet away from scoring.
Out to short. Throw on to Rizzo, and that is the inning. One left for Tampa, and the deficit remains 5-2. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Sean Armstrong.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
Giancarlo Stanton to the plate now.
With this kind of lead, he can swing freely, try to hit the ball out of the park, do what he loves to do.
Here's a 1-1. right through there for a strike.
Arm strong is what you're looking for in a good reliever. The ball stays in the ballpark. It's so hard to square him up. And the righty deals. Foul ball still, 1-2 count. And another ball.
Yeah, he stays out of the middle and pitches either at the bottom or at the top on the edges. And because of that, if you do get it in the air, it's usually just a high fly ball. And when it's down in the zone, it's on the ground.
Up next for the Yankees,
Anthony Rizzo getting ready to hit. He's so consistent that the manager basically can look at it like he's got three outs sitting in his pocket. That shortens the game. No. Next offering is down low. Tampa Bay's bullpen with some action. Garrett Clevenger up and loosening in the pen. Three-1 is on the way. There's a strike.
When he takes the mound, you feel like, hey, this inning is wrapped or this ball game is over. He's just that good. And you can see it in opposing hitters as well.
One down, base is empty. Foul. We'll see another payoff pitch.
They know when he comes in, pretty much forget about it. Kind of reminds me of Mariano Rivera.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And there's two down.
Chance to strike out the side now. You talk about the benefits, the advantages of relievers who can come in and get the swing and miss, whether it's inherited runners or maybe a little jam that they get into themselves. Knowing that they can miss the bat, tell you what, that's huge and can change the ballgame.
And that one cutting but missing down low. Swing, and that ball smashed on a line. Siri makes the play, and that is that. Down in order, go to Yankees. They're still out in front, 5-2. We're back. It's the top of the ninth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Clay Holmes. He has a great slider with tons of movement. So now here's the DH, Harold Ramirez. Right-handed reliever. And that one is lifted in the air. Soto makes the play. One away. He's two outs away. So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Richie Palacios. One down, base is empty. And now 2-2. Pitch. Caught and missed. Struck him out. Now only one out remaining. So they're down to their final out. Jose Siri next to hit for the Rays. Two down, nobody on. And another ball. That misses, and the count is 3-1.
Last couple of pitches, breaking balls away. I think he's going to have to come firm inside to be able to open up that location if he wants to go back there later in this count.
They're down to their final strike.
Wow, one fair right there. I mean, a slider didn't work to the very last moment. Incredibly difficult to pick that up. Just going to tip your cap on that pick.
And that should be extra bases. Now he turns and heads for second. The throw in, but he's in there easily.
That's tremendous fight from him, and I know it's got the dugout fired up down there. Down to the last strike, and he comes up with a hit to keep the game alive. It ain't over yet.
Man in scoring position with two away. And now, Jose Caballero. Pitches in the dirt. Two balls and a strike. Siri at second with two down. That's 2-1 pitches in there, and the count is even. The Rays down to their final strike. Is the ball game.
Whether you're a season ticket holder or you just come to a couple of games a year, to see your team win at home, there's just something special about that. Good job by this team to get it done for the hometown fans.
And your final score, 5-2. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Chompy saying so long.
Victorious Yankees, 5 runs, 8 hits, no errors. They left 5 runners on base.